Hey guys, a very good evening to all my crypto believers. So have you all been curious about what's happening in the market? Don't you worry, the CoinMonks got you covered. Okay, so before starting with the updates, let's quickly quote today's headlines. Twitter officially hires crypto team. Here's what to expect. Is Evergrow Coin's tax-free move a true masterstroke? Bitcoin miners look toward nuclear power for sustainable energy. Beeple's Discord compromised, time to coincide with Christie's auction. So let's start off with the refresh feed. We all know that Twitter had been planning to hire a crypto team, and now it looks like the rumors were true after all. Well, I wonder when will the other MNCs join this group too? Are you excited about this? Personally, I am. Let's see what our Twitter's Power Rangers up to. Twitter moved a step ahead with the official announcement of its crypto team formation following the introduction of the Bitcoin tipping tool and the NFT drop. This project, according to Tess Reinhardsen, the leader of Twitter's crypto team, intends to serve as a center of excellence for all things blockchain at Twitter. She stated that the team's goal will not be to limit cryptocurrencies, but that its reach will extend beyond cryptocurrencies and that they will seek to expand and improve crypto blockchains and other decentralized technologies on Twitter. I'm ecstatic to announce that I have joined Twitter to manage a new team focusing on cryptocurrencies, blockchains, and other decentralized technologies, including but not limited to cryptocurrency, said Tess Reinhardsen. Reinhardsen claimed that Twitter gets crypto, citing the company's previous Bitcoin tipping and NFT accomplishments. She also stated that there are several other layers to uncover and that the new crypto team will be tasked with figuring out what crypto can do for Twitter as well as what Twitter can do for crypto. Twitter's goal is to push the frontiers of the decentralized industry on its platform, from creators' efforts to use the decentralized sphere to promote their interests through NFTs and cryptocurrencies, to bringing in the community perspective on ownership and identity. In addition, the crypto team will work with the Blue Sky team to bring social media up to speed with decentralization's future. First, we'll look into how we might support creators' rising interest in using decentralized apps to manage virtual products and currencies, as well as to support their work and communities. We'll be looking into how concepts from crypto groups might help us push the frontiers of what's possible in terms of identity, community, ownership, and more in the future. According to Tess Reinhardsen's Twitter thread, of course, we'll be working closely with the Blue Sky team to help build the future of decentralized social media and to ensure that Twitter stays on the cutting edge of this new terrain too. So moving forward, so recently it came to news that Evergrow Coin has introduced a tax-free initiative. Well, we will mark this the beginning of the tax-free era in crypto exchanges. Maybe, maybe not, but it definitely is a nice step. How'll they earn then? Many questions still persist, so let's have a look at what's getting cooked. During the Evergrow Coin team's conference call on Sunday, they revealed details on how their planned centralized exchange listings will work in terms of tokenomics. Evergrow's unique reward system is part of the appeal that has driven them to break all prior crypto records in the first 6 weeks after debut. Many cryptos now provide rewards to holders, but Evergrow was the first major project to give stable, Binance-pegged US dollar payouts, and Evergrow Coin holders have already collected over $20 million in rewards in a short period of time. The distribution of incentives on controlled exchanges like Binance and Bitmart is a significant challenge because these platforms lack the infrastructure required to facilitate tokenomics. Over the previous 2 weeks, Evergrow has been working on this problem with a variety of exchanges, and it appears that their answer had baffled investors. But it could be the ultimate economic masterclass. Evergrow revealed that customers who invest on centralized exchanges will be able to buy and sell Evergrow without paying taxes, but will not be eligible for rewards. These traders might then transfer some or all of their tokens into an approved wallet if they choose to become investors. The initial reaction to this news was a mix of befuddlement and panic selling, resulting in a dramatic drop in the Evergrow coin price. However, now that investors have had time to examine the full consequences of this move, many analysts are predicting that this will be one of Evergrow's best moves ever. To properly comprehend the advantages of this strategy, a lot of layers must be dismantled. For starters, centralized exchanges have tens of millions of customers who historically exclusively trade on the exchange, which means they aren't used to paying taxes to acquire or sell a coin in 99% of circumstances. Despite the fact that currencies with taxes and rewards are now the fastest growing section of the cryptoverse, the vast majority of the world's estimated 50 million crypto traders trade on centralized exchanges through projects with no taxes or benefits. As a result, Evergrow's strategy was to tap into a massive market that previous similar companies had failed to tap into. The no tax, no incentives approach is perhaps the most reasonable way to offer more traditional consumers access to Evergrow. More traders and investors would logically lead to a growth in market cap, since demand for the token is predicted to explode once these listings go live, as cryptos cannot be effectively shorted. In essence, you cannot gamble on the price falling. When looking at the larger picture, it appears that what many consider a compromised answer is actually the best possible solution for all investors. Anyways, moving forwards with our next segment, apart from the lack of microtransactions, the only limit of Bitcoin is the conservation of energy. So I guess a solution has popped up, and it is the use of the sustainable energy. Day by day, the arguments of people hating crypto are decreasing. I wonder what's the next step. Let's dive into it. As pressure rises to become green, many companies in the Bitcoin mining business have their sights set on nuclear energy. Grid Vice President Hadi Sadak remarked at the Bitcoin and Beyond Virtual Summit on November 10 that nuclear energy might present a tremendous opportunity to deliver enormous volumes of pure, carbon-free energy to the base load. Grid is an American startup that develops vertically integrated Bitcoin mining operations using low-cost renewable energy. According to Sadak, previous renewable energy subsidy programs and rhetoric have mostly concentrated on solar and wind power, ignoring the potential benefits of nuclear energy. Right now, the growth rate is mostly focused on solar and wind, and this is simply the reality of the plans that have been implemented over the last 8 to 10 years. But we'd want to see nuclear power expand, he remarked. Along with Sadak, Blockstream Chief Strategy Officer Samson Mow was panelist to discuss the complexity of Bitcoin mining and energy use. FUD has a domineering role in talks on Bitcoin mining, according to Mow, which might lead to misunderstandings not only about Bitcoin mining, but also about energy production in general. The wider picture is often overlooked because Bitcoin mining accounts for such a small percentage of global energy use, like a fraction of a percent. Mow explained, if we're filthy, everything must be filthy, right? Mow is also a supporter of using nuclear energy to mine Bitcoin. The problem is, as a society, we've degraded to the point where we've rejected nuclear power in favor of alternatives like wind and solar, which are more expensive, more difficult to create, and don't always work, said Mow. The Bitcoin Mining Council conducted a survey of about 33% of the existing global Bitcoin network last month. According to BMC, the worldwide mining industry's sustainable electricity mix increased by nearly 3% to 55.9% in the third quarter of this year. At the summit, Amanda Fabiano observed, Bitcoin miners will go to the lowest type of electricity they can find. Fabiano is the head of mining Galaxy Digital, a digital asset investment management organization, and a founder member of BMC. I believe that capital with a long-term focus will thrive in Bitcoin mining. So moving towards our last segment, after a long time news including hackers, hey kids, are you excited? I mean, usually the younger audience gets hyped up whenever they hear about a hack. So here is a Discord community hack. Let's have a look at it. Overnight, an admin account for Beeple's official Discord group was hacked, resulting in a fraudulent NFT dump that cost consumers almost 38 ETH. On November 10, an admin named Multi from Beeple's Discord revealed to the group that their account had been compromised despite having 2FA. The offender then impersonated Multi and the Beeple announcements bot on Nifty Gateway to promote a phony NFT drop from Beeple. The incident is the most recent in a long line of Discord hacks that have resulted in a significant loss for users. Beeple has done it previously with raffles that saw people snap up NFTs for as little as $1, so Discord fans were expecting a cheap drop on the heels of his most recent sale. Fans kept an eye on Beeple's Twitter and the Discord channel all day for a chance to get some cheap NFTs. NFT Simon, a Discord user, told Cointelegraph that he had set up his MetaMask wallet and was ready to pounce just in case. I didn't blink twice when the verified Beeple bot and the verified administrator posted on the official Beeple Discord with a link to a NFT gateway website. I went over there and started minting as much as I could, as quickly as I could, he explained. NFT Simon and 6 Beeple NFTs in his possession, or so he believed, but he couldn't see them on his Nifty account. When he returned to Discord, he was shocked to discover the bogus admin was writing in all caps. I was welcomed by a slew of obscene GIFs of naked men from a variety of individuals. It was obviously a ruse, and Beeple's Discord had been hacked. In reaction to the lack of communication, one user suggested that a calming and understanding announcement instead of a pinned message might make things easier to swallow. This was not a simple DM with a link, but a massive security breach that lasted for about about an hour with no mods present. So we would now wind up with the assessment for today evening and meet you all tomorrow with even more interesting stuff. Until then, you may consider joining Telegram for free crypto signals. Visit our blog linked below for guides, reviews and tutorials, and subscribe to the channel and get daily updates about the crypto market. Lastly, with this little favor of CoinMonks, we hope you stay updated. Thanks for watching and have a nice day ahead.